I wasn't really sure how to make a video for the NIKKOR 20mm F1.8S lens for the Nikon Z series, and I figure the easiest way is to just show you how I use it. And as a run and gun style just video lens, it's absolutely phenomenal. As a photography lens, we'll get to that in a little bit, also amazing, but the versatility of it really is just incredible. One of the other things with the Nikon Z series, it's 20mm prime, but you can go into DX mode, so it turns into kind of a 30mm prime, so you're able to get even more versatility out of just having a single lens. I love the size of this lens specifically. It's so easy to just bring with you everywhere to just have in your bag. I think that about all of the 1.8 primes. And I would also say, if you are interested in just purchasing only two of the primes for Z series, I would say something like the 20mm prime and the 85 would be the perfect combination for really anything that you could find yourself in as far as portraits and wedding days go. A 24 is also very good, but I find the 20 just a little bit more versatile, specifically when it gets dark for astrophotography. So super happy to have this lens. This is the lens that I'm using the most when it comes to self-filming. It's just easy, I'm just holding it with my hand. And it's just easy. You don't get tired. You're not holding like 3 kilograms of gear, just holding a 20. I'm very happy that this lens exists. I used the original F-mount 21.8 for years with my digital SLRs, and I loved it. The Z series version obviously gets some significant upgrades in build quality, optics, silent autofocus, which is great for video. Plus, when you add the in-body stabilization from the Nikon Z6 II, it makes hand-holding this lens great for video and allows for some really low handheld shutter speeds if ever required. The customizable control ring can be set to fluid aperture transitions, exposure compensation, or ISO. Another great thing with the Nikon 20mm prime is that it's weather sealed, so when you're out in conditions like this, you don't have to worry too hard. So you're able to actually capture images with snow and with elements in them. And if you can just come out here and just get the images you want, and you don't have to worry about your gear and getting wet or getting covered in snow or ice or whatever it might be, it just makes for better images and a better photography experience overall. And I will say, for a scene like the one directly behind me over here, the 24mm is pretty close to what I want. But what I actually want is 20mm, so I'm super happy that I brought that prime with me just to get a little bit more of the foreground trees here, since I'm on a bridge and I can't really take a few steps back in this specific case. So in this case, it is important to have that wide angle lens. And maybe again, that is a testament to how easy it is to bring this 20 with you, to put it in your bag. You know, it's not gonna weigh you down. I'm going snowboarding later today. So if I was to be going snowboarding with a very, very heavy lens, I probably would have left it in the hotel, but I am super happy that I brought it out here with my 24-70, because I just need those extra few millimeters to get those close trees. And I'm actually gonna stop this down to something like F4 and turn my ISO up just a little bit. Just give a little more depth of field. With the 20, your infinity line isn't really too far away. It's basically just on the edge of what I would consider to be compositionally great at 20mm. So super, super happy that I brought this lens. One of the obvious reasons to purchase this lens is for low light photography. Right now, tail end of blue hour, this lens is performing phenomenally paired with the Nikon Z6 II body. We're actually gonna head out to Vermilion Lakes and we're going to do some astrophotography to really show you what is possible with this lens. The reason that I love it for astrophotography is because it's a wide prime, so you're able to get your ISO as low as possible and get as much of the night sky in as you possibly can. It's a little difficult to film an astro demonstration, but basically what's happening is we're on just kind of the small piece of ice here that's completely frozen over top of a little bit of water, getting a very nice reflection over Rundle Mountain. The city is actually lighting up the clouds a little bit and the stars are out, so this is coming together really well. The 20mm 1.8, I'm actually kind of, the way that I go about astro is that I'll just set up a 15 second exposure. So I'll go manual settings, 15 seconds, F1.8, which is amazing. This lens does it. And then I'll figure out what my ISO needs to be. Right now I'm at about ISO 400 and running that 15 second exposure. So on the screen you are seeing some of the images. And as you can see, really, really phenomenal optical quality, edge to edge sharpness. Everything is just great. I'm just super happy with this lens, and it is the lens, I would say, if you're out here and you want to do photos like this. So I actually borrowed this lens from NPS, and when I came home from this trip, I ended up purchasing it, so maybe that speaks to how important and how useful I find this lens. That is all for today. If you're interested in seeing more of our trip out to the Canadian Rocky Mountains,
There's a link in the description below. You can head over there. You can come with us on the entire trip. See you there.